Thank you. Tantalus. The curtains were partially drawn when G entered the deluxe single. The exposed window revealed the landmark of the city of B, which lavishly embossed the room of a bar. G, and Necessus, the mother of two, has long coveted the chance to take some days off to visit her ex-boyfriend. Their relationship had come to an end about 6 months prior. She started to unpack her suitcase while making a phone call. She behaves differently in her hotel room than she would in her home. In hotels, she tends to utilize the elements of the room as little as possible. But once she availed herself of anything in the room, she always did it crudely and with the utmost visual strength. Red tiles were thrown under the bathtub and on the bed, while most of the amenities remained untouched. G's indulgence in vanity was realized and elaborated by her playful arrangements of the effortless. As she finished aligning her skincare bottles over the curb of the bathroom's mirrors, she made another phone call. When a precise, moderate amount of anxiety circumscribes the tips of G's hand and over the muscles of her neck, her exterior was more nonchalant than ever. G never earned a sufficient understanding of her anxieties. The indecipherability was constitutional. It was right under the tips of her dominant hand where her anxiety echoed. And, in fact, her anxiety induced in her everything that was not anxious. Her pretty carelessness manifested similarly to the condensation of humid air. Her exterior collects itself as droplets from without as the anxiety can barely remain inside and, in turn, edges against the contours of her gestural body. Her anxiety is the dire surface of her innermost self. The motif of the anxious is never shown there, despite its fragile proximity to G's exterior. When one's mysteries are bulging, anxiety is the form of embossment. G always found women embossed with their namesake's anxiety very enticing. If her anxiety were the dire surface of her inmost self, what covers the surface of her body? And if the condensation physic would have actually managed to express how remarkably coined G's outfit is, only marginally, where does the transformation come about? If one was reminded that a wall is always comprised of lateral surfaces, what is it that begins a wall? At what point does a wall adjoin its dual plane? If she had perspired, to what extent was this part of her body succeeding in keeping distance? As a means of brushing that particular emotion aside, while at the same time not brushing it aside.
Thank you.
Easel, noun. Easel, plural noun, easels. A wooden frame for holding an artist's work while it's being painted or drawn. Origin, 16th century. From Dutch, ezel, ass. The word horse is used in English in a similar way to the noun for supporting a frame. From Oxford Languages. R is great legs. He is a tall, good-looking guy who works as a bartender. Alcohol hardly makes him stumble, though he has only had a petty number of shots. He readily dictates his unaffected body by holding onto the banisters each time he walks down or up the staircase. It is 9 o'clock, he exits his lover's door, then walks down 5 flights of a 7-story building. They fuck like kids for hours. As R walks down the five perpendicular rounds, unbeknownst to him, a thin layer of grease is repeatedly marked over the elbows of the banisters. They are probably from his lover A's body lotion. This habitual, unnecessary caution of R's is now taking a rhythmic appearance. In a way, it resembles a freshly pulled strand of hair curled up right away due to his youth. November morning's campers, brief sunlight is pierced through the raining window in accordance to R's descending 5 times. The minute sunlight kills the subtlety of the grease marks, which are invisible otherwise. As if his walking down coincides with an ordeal of piano art, the sunlight, instead of R, does the job of depressing the pedal, the banisters, preventing the dampers from stopping the memory when the keys are released. The motion marks remain visible for about an hour after you left the building. Eventually, they dry off and start to wane. Around 11 o'clock, A got up from his bed. At times, still half asleep, the rectangle of sunlight peeked into the back of his head. He, who equally cares about his dog and his carpets, had no plans for the day. He decides to walk his dog. He knows the bus to be in the street. His dog slept briefly. It would rain again soon, he thought. A made a noise with the dog's leash, and within a second, it awoke and trembled with joy. The dog added another fresh scratch of excitement to the bottom of the door. With his left foot, A gently dragged his dog aloof from the sectoral path of the door, while he simultaneously pulled the door open with his right hand. The brief elongation of one short hand, A's diagonal limbs resembled the series of hand motions one uses when capturing a piece on a chessboard. The hinged door captures in the same manner as the palm. The palm captures the roar of the excited animal. Nevertheless, A's dog always patiently pauses at the staircase and awaits A's arms to carry it down. It has never been otherwise, although something was different today. In front of the staircase, the dog discovered a scent so dear to its masters. The dog was momentarily amazed that it would smell something of its feeder from metal that was disconnected from A's body and house. It happened in seconds. The stupid dog jumped to reach a point of olfactory curiosity. The banister was double the length of its fully stretched body, so it plummeted straight to the ground floor. Its body was insignificant. Easel. Easel. Noun. Easel. Plural noun. Easels. A wooden frame for holding an artist's work while it is being painted or drawn. Origin, 16th century. From Dutch, ezel, ass. The word horse is used in English in a similar way to denote a supporting frame. From Oxford Languages.
Thank you. Thank you.